You've probably seen the app that makes pictures of you look older, and you may have seen these alarming headlines warning about FaceApp. It's now the top free app on iTunes, but some say it's a huge security risk. KCTV5's Betsy Webster took a deeper look beyond the headlines to see if you really have anything to worry about.
For singers, that's Carrie Underwood, to actors, like Terry Crews, to athletes, sharp suit, Dwayne Wade, the app that ages with AI is getting a lot of buzz.
It's pretty funny. Yeah, I send it to friends and whatnot.
Drew Lutsky did it.
My daughter just did it this morning.
Gail Schimmel was not pleased with its predictive powers.
I haven't posted it, though.
But Mark Meisenheimer said we could.
Several people in our newsroom have tried this app. I decided today that I would try it as well. This is what I look like aged. My first thought was, oh my gosh, do I look like my mom? And my mom looks better at 79 than I do in this picture. I did all of this after learning about the security risks, which involve the multitude of information that an app can gather while running in the background of your phone, as well as, in this case, where the app came from.
It's really not anything new. It's just because it's from Russia. It's kind of scary.
For Josh Wade, a small business tech consultant with the Purple Guys, scary is in air quotes. But CNN reported today that the Democratic National Committee's chief security office warned presidential campaign staff not to use it because of campaigns being hit by Russian hackers in 2016. App staff told TechCrunch today, we don't sell or share any user data with any third parties. And even though the core R&D team is located in Russia, the user data is not transferred to Russia. The concern, well, there's what they say and what they do.
Russia's going to just hand out everything that they can, you know. That is very concerning to me.
No doubt the app can access all your photos and could access your location or geo-tracking if it wanted to, but
I'm not concerned.
Why not?
I don't know. I'm not a celebrity. I'm not running for president. And if anybody wants my photo, I suppose they can have it.
I feel like all that information's already out there.
What are they going to get? What are they going to get from me? Pictures of me and my wife or a selfie? I don't know what they would do with that.
Your location?
Okay, I'm in Kansas City. Come and get me. I mean, what are they going to do with that?
Worst case scenario for an ordinary person, I would say if you have any, copied receipts or you have information in your photos that you took a screenshot of, your bank statements or stuff like that. LinkedIn's been hacked, Facebook's been hacked. It's just a matter of what they're actually doing with the data.
Usually, that's marketing.
That would probably be the most worrisome thing, and that's not really a worry. It's more of an annoyance.
But the what if has some thinking twice about all apps, not just the ones from Russia or China.
When these new, fun, exciting things come along, we do have to think about that, and I think we don't.
Betsy Webster, KCTV 5 News.